Some folks say introducing covered bonds to America is a great idea. Treasury Secretary Paulson believes they'll help jumpstart the mortgage market, but not everyone likes them, including Congressman Scott Garrett. Congressman joins us now from D.C. So, Congressman, what don't you like about them?
Well, I do like them. I like taking one step further than just the Treasury Secretary and the FDIC coming out with their proposals and regulations. I think what's absolutely necessary is for the legislature, for the Congress, to step forward and put some of this in statute. And the reason for that is we want to have additional security for the marketplace so they know exactly what's going to be the law, what's going to be the rules, and what's the ground rules going forward.
So do you think that they will help the mortgage market right now?
Oh, absolutely. I've been looking at this for some period of time now, and obviously covered bonds, as you indicated, have a history in the world, a history in Europe that go back to the 1700s. And in Europe, as you know, they don't have something like we have here with the Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac and the GSEs. And so they don't have the same problems that we've experienced because of that. But at the same time, they've been able to develop the housing market and the mortgage market over there through the covered bond mechanism. And what we're suggesting is we should be able to do that, expand it here, but do it with more security to the marketplace so that investors will know that this is exactly what they're getting when they get into these debt instruments.
Well, that's a good idea. Maybe you can explain, you know, how these are different from the mess that got us into where they repackage the mortgage loans and then sell them off.
Well, that you said it right there as to what got us into the mess right here is that we had instruments that were packaged up in any way, shape, or form, I guess, and without any really great credit agencies rating them to say exactly what are you getting here, and then they were sold into the marketplace. And the folks who were doing the underwriting, of course, with mortgage-backed securities really didn't care because they know that as soon as they packaged them all together and sold them out there, if somebody bought them, you might say that their hands were clean and they were done with it. With a covered bond, that's a different situation entirely because the investment entities basically, or rather the entities that would be issuing these things, which would be banks basically, they would have to keep them on the books. And so there is the big difference, is the banks are going to have to look at them and say, if these are going to stay on my balance sheet, I'm going to make darn sure that the underwriting going into these mortgages, principally residential mortgages probably in the first instance, I'm going to make sure that the underwriting is good because I'm going to be responsible for them. And then they execute a debt instrument that goes out there. And so the credit rating, the last point, the credit rating is going to be a lot higher on these.
But I'd see the problem with that, though, since the banks are going to be so tough on their lending standards, we're still not going to get any mortgages made because it's so tough. And if they're going to keep them on the books, it's going to still be tough.
Well, it certainly is going to be tougher than what we've had over the last couple of years as far as underwriting, or last year and a half or so, because really, in reality, we had no underwriting standards whatsoever. People who had, no income, no job verifications, no jobs whatsoever, were able to go out into the investment world and say, give me a mortgage. I want to buy a $500,000 house, even though I don't have a job, I can't afford this. And they were given mortgages. And that was ridiculous. That's what got us into this. You know, lots of fingers, blames to go around here. Government and sort of encourage these things. We have to get away from that. We do want good underwriting standards, and hopefully with just a prudent underwriting standards and a way for the banks to keep it on the balance sheet, we'll get more liquidity than if we don't do anything.
Congressman Scott Garrett, thanks so much.
Appreciate
it. Cody?
Thanks.
Thanks, Rebecca. Our next guest is the head of a company that